Welcome back, Executor, Miss Shirley, and Miss Brevi from Hycros. We've made ample preparations for our in-depth partnership. Please.
The Infinite Sundial? That's the most important facility in Domain 9 for.
That's right. The Infinite Sundial transfers the field energy.
Very fascinating. I'd Is it just the novelty?
Of course.
Welcome, Miss Brevi. Let me introduce Miss Brevi, the architect of the Tower of Fantasy from Highcross. She'll be conducting an inspection regarding the
First things first. We have to ensure that Domain 9 is within Mara's energy radiation range before we can move forward with the next steps. If we can confirm this, maybe we could prove that Domain 9 is a part of Ida. Just maybe. For some reason, Domain 9 and the other regions have become isolated from each other. What's the principle behind the deployment of this barrier? In any case, if this is true, it falls in line with Hycros' prior hypothesis. Domain 9, just like Vera and Asperia, is another missing...
Miss Brevi's ideas are quite promising for further study. It seems that this verification process might unearth key... I'll leave it up to Miss Brevi to take the lead.
Before we move forward, I have a question. How exactly did Domain 9 pin...
Domain 9 experienced a very unusual space-time fluctuation some time ago. Due to the impact of the fluctuation, the data was harvested and processed by three space-time anchor stations in Joltville. It was... Therefore, we precisely identified the location of the outside world celestial...
I see. Just as I had imagined, then we can replicate the same procedure this time. But given that Mara exists in higher dimensional space-time, we need to adjust the survey parameters.
Of course, that's not a problem. Neo.
Understood.
Moreover, taking into account the time required, we can accomplish the same goal by modifying...
Modifying the infinite sundial? Wouldn't that interfere with the functioning of the whole timestamp system?
We'll have to determine that based on the actual circumstances. However, if the two facilities operate independently, it could potentially lead to a large-scale energy. In that situation, Tower of Fantasy's energy efficiency would significantly decrease, possibly not meeting the infinite. All things considered, remodeling the infinite sundial is the best solution.
Tianzhang Pavilion will carefully evaluate the proposal. It's absolutely critical that we ensure the infinite sundial continues to function perfectly. There's no room for error.
I'll leave the proposal evaluation to Mimi. In the meantime, our priority is to survey the existence of Mara.
Please follow me to Tianzhang Pavilion, and we can discuss the plans for the anchoring device modification.
My name is Yoon, and I oversee the Infinite Sundial. I'd be delighted to assist in any way I can.
A new member just joined our party? Our group's friendship EXP just got a major boost!
I just did a quick calculation of the transmission power needed for the survey. And as for how to equip the space-time anchor stations with the ability to survey...
Right. For that, we just need to request Hycros to transport...
I see. Miss Brevi must be planning to replace the existing modules of the space-time anchor stations with the ones from Hycros, right?
That's right! Our collective brain...
But it seems like it won't be as simple as that. The device doesn't fit...
This could be troublesome. The space-time anchor...
We'll help too. What resources do you need?
Thank you, Executor. Allow me a moment to prepare a list. Roughstone and Jadestone should be relatively easy. The Dark Gold Fixator can be purchased to...
Sounds straightforward enough. I'll head out now.